Hello everyone, I'm Wadiv Nortmerson and I'm part of Fun Propulsion Labs at Google. So what we do is we create libraries and tools to try and improve game development on Android and beyond. One such library is FlatBuffers. So FlatBuffers is a library that's going to make your game load faster and use less memory. Because ask yourself, how much time are you spending loading data? Loading data can be expensive because usually game data is represented differently on disk than it is in memory. It might be compressed to save space, or it might be stored as text so that humans can edit it. So the process of converting between the two is what we call serialization. Now, serialization is kind of cool because data in memory can focus on what it's good at, which means being fast and easy to modify. Meanwhile, data on disk can also focus what it's good at, being compact, machine independent, and being forwards, backwards compatible. But serialization also kind of sucks because all this packing and unpacking takes time. It uses additional memory since we have to unpack the serialized data into objects, and format changes can be quite error prone. So in games in particular, use a lot of data, as you know. Is there a way we can fix this? Well, this all comes from the assumption that memory and disk must be inherently incompatible ways of storing things. But what if we try anyway? Well, then you get FlatBuffers. So what FlatBuffers really is a portable binary format that allows you to store things on disk the same as in memory, meaning you can move from one to the other without any conversion. It works well on disk because it has fixed rules for data sizes, alignment, and endianess on all platforms. It deals with forwards and backwards compatibility, which means you can add and remove fields at will. It also works well in memory. Everything is reachable through offset, so it's very fast. It works from read-only media, which is very cool. And it's more compact and cache-friendly than separately allocated objects. So at this point, I can tell you're all convinced and you just want to use FlatBuffers. So how do you do that? Well, first you write a schema. Then you give this schema to our friendly compiler who will generate code for you in your favorite language, if assuming your favorite language is one of these four. Then you load up this generated code in your game and you read and write FlatBuffer data. So schemas is pretty important for efficiency, and it also allows you to access your data without error checking. And schemas can be changed without having to regenerate all your data. So for example, you can update your game and all your old save games still work. So what can you stick in a FlatBuffer? There is the usual suspects over here. Then to support forwards and backwards compatibility, we have tables where fields can be added and removed at will. And this goes through an indirection called a virtual table. Then we also have structs. If you want the maximum efficiency, these don't support format evolution, but they're the fastest way to store data. And finally, we have enums, unions, and other cool things. So let's have a look how this is implemented under hood. So this is what an object looks like in memory. It starts off with an offset to a virtual table which contains the offsets to the actual fields. Now, these virtual tables are shared between similar objects, so they're actually not that expensive. Then what follows is the actual fields, all in line, including the structs. And then finally, if you have a reference to bigger data, that goes through an offset indirection. So let's look at some C++ code, how you would use this. You'd first get a pointer to your root object. Then you would use field accessors to actually look at the data, and these hide all the offset lookups for you. So very convenient. Creation using a FlatBuffer builder helper class, and then you call these create functions, which will create objects inside that buffer for you. So I know this all sounds incredibly fast, but how fast is it really? So let's compare against some popular other serialization solutions. And of course, you should take benchmarks with a grain of salt, but I still think you'll find these interesting. So if you're going to read a FlatBuffer, then you'll find it's over 1,000 times faster than other solutions. And this is, of course, because we're not actually parsing or allocating anything. Writing a FlatBuffer is still about 100 times faster, still pretty good. Then we're not actually allocating any objects when we're reading, so that's great. And finally, the code is also really small, both the generated code and the library code. At this point, though, you might say, I don't care, I'm still going to use text because it's easier to work with. Well, guess what? FlatBuffers also supports JSON out of the box. So that means you can convert to binary format either on the fly in your game or as a preprocess with our command line tool. And that's everything I've got. Come find us online or come talk to me at GDC. Thank you.